All right, hello everybody. We're here at Melrose Elementary School where we have some student inventors. Why don't we start by you introducing yourselves?
Hello, my name is Imani.
Hi, my name is Idrees.
And my name is Jadiel.
And my name is Tina Classfeature.
All right, well, we'll start with, can you tell me about what the project, what the program is and how that all got started with you folks? We'll start with...
The students were given a scenario. They were asked to compete in a competition through the Cal Ripken Foundation to create an invention that would help a blind student maneuver themselves around the classroom. So, you want to start, Idrees? Go ahead. What did we decide?
We decided that we were going to create a shoe that had a sensor in front of it. So, and it would vibrate on the person's foot because it's supposed to be in the classroom and they're supposed to be navigating throughout the classroom. And whenever it vibrates, it doesn't make that much noise, so people in the classroom can still concentrate.
Oh, wow. And who came up with that idea? Was that the three of you, or?
I thought I came up with
it. I think Idrees came up with the idea, and Jadiel came up with the name of our sneaker. What was the name of our sneaker?
It was a sneaker. It was called the Seeker. Now, it kind of had a pun in it. So, there's the word sneaker. You just have to take away the N, and it has a C in it.
Okay, so it's called the Seeker, then.
Seeker,
okay,
Seeker.
Oh, wow. All right. And we will be demonstrating that in just a moment here, but can you tell me what the steps were in coming up with the Seeker? How did that work?
First, we had to like draw it out before we started building anything. And then once we came up with the idea, we bought the parts online and started building the shoe. But we couldn't do it by ourselves. We still needed the IT guy to help us solder things and help us figure out problems with the breadboard.
Now, what kind of parts did you need?
We needed a breadboard. We bought some shoes so when we came up with the idea, we could use the sensors on the shoes. And we had to buy like a couple of sensors, so when we had like our different prototypes, we would still have some sensors left.
And why don't you show me the shoes so we can see what the sensors look like? And okay. Oh, okay.
Turn it around.
All right, yeah, and what is that, the sensor on the front there?
Yeah, that's a sonar.
Right here.
Okay.
That's a sonar sensor. Okay.
And what were the steps in creating that? Can you tell me what the three of you went through to do that?
We had to create two other prototypes.
Yeah.
This is one of them.
This is our second.
This is our second.
This was our first prototype. That was the one.
We figured out all the wiring except for a few wires that it wouldn't work. That's why we needed the IT guy.
Okay. Can you explain to me what's all going on with that prototype there?
Because this is the sonar sensor. This is the light that's supposed to change color when objects placed at different distances. This is the wiring to help it function, and this, you plug it in for it to work. But there's no battery
and
vibrator.
And when we were looking at the instructions, it said to put a wire in a certain place, but one of the instructions were wrong. So it didn't work. That's why our teacher contacted an IT person, and he came and said that it was wrong. There was something wrong with it.
And can you folks describe the second prototype that you have there, the blue one or the purple one?
This one?
Yeah. What's going on with that one?
Well, it's kind of like a smaller version as the first prototype, but then there was this big problem. What it would do, it would vibrate the vibration piece loose. So then the shoe wouldn't work properly. Right now,
because when it was vibrating, sometimes it would go high, that this flap right here
would
make it vibrate whenever it wants to. And then whenever it vibrated, it sometimes moves back into the shoe, and then it just doesn't work.
Also, you would have to get really close to
something
for it to
vibrate.
Close.
See?
So it was supposed to go 18 inches, but this is not even 18 inches. It's not vibrating. But you have to be like a few, like an inch for it to vibrate.
This one.
So that was your second one. What's the one that ended up working? Is that the next one?
Yep, this one.
Oh, wow.
And this one, we both told Imani where to put the wires on it. Like, on here, we had to stick the wires in different places. And on this one, we just had to do the exact same thing on this shoe, but this is just littler.
Okay. Now, can you describe what's going on there? Is that that's the sensor on the front?
Yep, yeah, this one right here.
Same thing on here. Wow. This is the battery pouch. We just put the battery in it, and then I strap it around my leg and plug it into the shoe.
See?
Wait.
Oh, wow.
And then,
and you see
when the,
see how it's dimming, right?
And then when you get farther,
it turns
it gets green, a little bit greenish.
And then it turns red.
All right, well, how about a demonstration of how that works? Can you do a live demonstration here?
Yeah.
Do we need our boxes, or can we just use anything?
I can use any box to quite imagine.
You got your boxes, too.
Oh. This one's my box.
I need my blindfold.
So go get one of those stools.
Okay. Can you describe what you're doing there? You're putting the battery pack on your
ankle.
On your ankle and connecting it to the shoe.
With the blindfold.
And while you're getting ready, can you tell me what you learned from the experience? What all did you gain from doing this project?
We learned how to, we watched somebody solder, and that was cool.
A lot about engineering and a lot about technology.
Yeah.
Wow. And how much work went into it? How much time do you think you put in all together?
How much? Like a month?
Since November.
Since November? Okay.
It took and they presented in December.
Okay.
It took a pretty long time because we had all the different prototypes, and we learned how to program our boards. What are we using?
Okay. All right, and you're putting on a blindfold? Okay. All right, describe what you're doing. You're putting on a blindfold, and you're wearing the shoes.
Tell me what you're doing.
We're placing the boxes so that when I walk, I can sense the obstacle with my shoe.
Okay.
Excuse me, can you give us another demonstration and tell me what you're feeling? Because I could hear it vibrating. Could you do that? Like as you get close and then when you're really close.
If you walk slowly.
Yeah.
It just gets louder.
It
gets louder, and the feeling like
kind of tickles, doesn't it?
Yeah. All right, and then what happened? You entered this in a competition.
Yeah.
Okay, and describe what that was like. Was it with?
It was with 200 people. It was with 200 teams, but only one of the teams could make it, and we had to Skype with the other team.
Okay.
And we were actually the winners and won $2,000 for our school.
Oh wow!
And we got a plaque.
Great, and we got the plaque right there. All right, and from this whole experience, what's next for you folks? Are you still going to look into the sciences and technology for your next project?
Yep.
What do you want to do next?
We're working on Legos.
You want to build that robot with the wheels, the remote control one.
Oh, wow. With Legos.
That yes.
Oh, I know. So that's
all right. And what did you learn from the whole experience? What did you learn about science and what you might want to do when you grow up?
I learned that I wanted to be an engineer because I thought that while we were doing all this stuff, I thought it was a lot of fun.
Right.
I learned that maybe any sciences would be okay because just science is fun in general.
What did you learn? You want to be a scientist?
I learned that engineering is really confusing, but it's also really fun.
All right, thank you very much.
What do you say?